My name is Rhapsody, welcome back to Enter the Gungeon! Time to go with the Hunter. I just double hit the alt uniform, but she has the world's best alt uniform, so I'm definitely going to be wearing it, I think. Yep, we've finished this one, and the next is for what again? Excuse me? One more time, Bullet Shark. Okay, beautiful. 20 Bullet Sharks in a single run? There's a few rooms that have like 6 in them. I don't think you can get 20 in a single run. Or at least I think it's really unlikely. Whoa, bring us back up. Alrighty then, let's go with the crossbow. Ah! Yeah, I knew that was gonna happen. Because I was already holding out the wrong weapon. Ah, well. Thankfully, I only took melee damage there, so it wouldn't have stopped me from getting money from that GG if I was gonna get money from that GG. So, nothing of value has been lost. Unless, of course, I end up getting cigarettes on this floor, in which case, fuck. I just lost the coolness. Thank you for the key. Holy crap. Bye. That's the first time I've ever seen that room. I love it. Good room. Best room. So I do want to be using the rusty sidearm against the signature enemies, so that's the gun nuts and the chain gunners on this floor. Because there's no real reason to just waste crossbow ammunition against them, it's not necessary. Hell, it doesn't even really help my kill time on them. Okay, it can't even spawn there. Right, teleport back. Didn't know that was going to be an item room. If I had have known it was going to be an item room, I wouldn't have even bothered entering. Because I don't want it to be an item room, and then that item room turns out to have a fuse on it, then I have to open the chest, and then I don't get to force the weapon from the boss. I should stick far left. I think this is going to be the boss over here. All right. Pretty good character to be fighting this enemy with. Simply because I can keep my distance like no other character really can afford to. And also, it's a reasonable damage output from the crossbow. Cut across before he does the circle attack. Man, he has been really kind. That's the first circle attack he's done. The only attack that I really give a name here is the circle attack. So while he does many attacks that do kind of have that kind of shape, I only call one of them the circle attack. That one. Because it's a single circle that then splits into bullets that go in all different directions, and that can be problematic. Woohoo! Don't mind if I do. That's a good gun right there, right there. See, this is a weird placement. Usually they're not this close, but they are. Okay, we've already got 2 key drops. Still haven't got our shop. I'm going to force the key in the shop. So that's 4 keys. If I don't want to open my second chest on this floor, so if it's brown or something like that, then I can go to the oubliette. So I should try and guarantee that I leave the water barrel alive. I should always try and guarantee that, but especially right now. I think it's still, yeah, beautiful. It's still alive so far. Oh, it almost died there, though. Okay. Oh, if we get the triple spawn here, I'm gonna be so happy. Yes, we did! Hey, what up, gun nut? The triple spawn is just so much more money. On top of a room that already gives you a really reasonable amount. Oh, it only gave me 4. Lame. We're still pretty far ahead the amount of money that we should have by this point in the game. Okay, so there's our oubliette entrance. Definitely taking double vision. Okay. found our secret room, so I probably don't have to check for the rest of them. Double vision plus that is going to require 60, so I only need 9 more. For the double vision plus the key. Never mind, I might not even need the key. I mean, I'd still like the key, but I might not need it. Beautiful. That? No, we're exactly one off. Okay, come on. Bring it home. All right, you already did. Thank you very much. There, we got the exact one that I needed. Shit, I might have exactly the amount I needed as well. Okay, beautiful. Check if there's a second secret room. If there is a second secret room, it'd be adjacent to a normal room rather than this, so... I will be destroying this. Not really too much can convince me otherwise on that. Coming back there. We dropped the dog. Alright. Let's go pick up double vision key. Then we'll go get our two key opportunities. And we'll pick up our green chest. Beautiful, beautiful first floor here. We're going down with no extra money to the oubliette, but we're going down with two keys. So even if the shop is locked, we'll be able to open both of the chests on that floor. It's pretty good. Pretty damn good. That's unfortunate. I might actually want to sell this right now. It's close, but I'm not going to. But what if something so good is in the shop next floor? I'm going to be getting two weapons next floor regardless. I could save this for a gun muncher, but gun munchers seem to be more rare. You know what? I'm gonna sell it. I think in the future, I'm gonna regret if I don't sell that right now. That's a solid 30. That could be huge come next floor. Think about it like this. Last run, 41. So not last run, but the last run that I commentated over because I did the post-commentary recently. That run had exactly enough money to buy the Lama Configurum on the Oubliette, and that was, you know, pretty much pivotal to that entire run. That was the whole run right there in the Lama Configurum. Hey, got him! I keep forgetting about the shot speed of these enemies. Gotta remember that. It's like the key factor about them. Found the secret room as well. I don't need to guarantee the flawless on this floor, so... In some cases, I might consider taking damage in this room just to trigger the blank effect from losing my armor so that I can open that secret room. But that's only if I need to conserve my blanks. And I don't need to. Because I don't need to be using a bunch of blanks against the boss. This one needed to die first. Crap. I'm just gonna wait here. Can't take that. It's good that I spent a second there immobilized so that I wouldn't just immediately try and pick it up and then regret it. Yeah, I'm definitely going to take damage if I try and go around that way. I hate that room. I take damage every single time. So I'm going to try and go this way. See if it links back up to it. Okay, all good in the hood. What? Well, that was lame. I was pretty certain I was fine there. Nothing I want to purchase on this floor. It's a shame. Well, dang. Both of those will just die to their poison, so I can just wait. Yeah, it looks very likely that the boss room is... Never mind. I didn't say anything. I don't know what you thought I said. No, it looks very likely the boss room is up here. Got him. Just wait up here. Thank you. I should try not to be so hasty to leave the rooms. Because that will eventually result in me, you know, leaving a room that has ammo dropped on the floor or armor dropped on the floor. Thankfully, it hasn't resulted in that yet. All right, go fight the boss. Okay, so it's one in between those. Got it. Thankfully, I was rolling when I made that contact. Otherwise, I would have taken damage there. Again, I don't need to flawless this boss, but it'd be nice. Just as a boost for my self-esteem, if anything else. Oh, okay. Don't mind if I do. We'll refill the crossbow now. Don't need to pick that up. Oh no, I have been to the shop. Never mind, we're fine. Cool. Got a hell of a lot of money so far. And we've now got a boss weapon for next floor as well. Here's our... Damn it. Another secret room that just sucks. Oh. Oh, whoa, what's this? I think that's actually worth it. That's a lot of armor. Like two pieces of armor and a shot at a blue chest. I think I'd take that. Sucks. I've lost two armor on this floor so far. Really shouldn't have lost any. Pox cannon's incredible. That's unfortunate. I don't think I have a sales grate. Yeah, no, we don't have a sales grate, so we're not going to be taking that. Take the key, blank the shop. All right, I'm going to go take these as well. Gungeon pepper. That's unfortunate. So Gungeon pepper was actually like a really recent item of the day discussion on Enter the Gungeon subreddit. I pitched in my thoughts about it. I think it's pretty good on the bullet, pretty bad on everyone else. It helps you one-shot a lot of targets when you're playing the bullet. Simply because as the bullet, you don't have to worry about contact damage, so you can get really up close and personal with someone. So the Gungeon pepper, which does area of effect damage around you in a small radius, will be triggering a lot of the time, but you also want to get up close and personal so you can do the blasphemy swings that will hit with both the melee and the projectile elements, and then plus the Gungeon pepper damage, you start one-shotting enemies that you would not previously have one-shotted that late in the game. Which is nice. It can be really nice. That should have gone into the regular shotbow. Regular shotbow, regular crossbow, rather. Regular shotgun. I went the wrong direction 2 times. I merged the shotgun with the crossbow, and then I just took the shotgun out of the equation entirely. It's somewhere on this wall, probably. Never mind, I've never said anything to that effect. Club. That's interesting. First bullet shock. Here we go. Got him. Oh, fuck! I knew it. I knew that was gonna happen eventually. I called it last floor as well. Sadly, knowing that it was gonna happen doesn't prevent it from having had happened. Having had happened? Yeah, no, I apparently know English. There's actually also another recent thread on the Enter the Gungeon subreddit that was talking about most hated enemies. And there were so many people who hated lead maidens. I don't understand it. Unless it's that room in hell where you have a lead maiden and 2 skullmets at the same time. I don't understand. Lead maidens aren't that bad. Personally, I guess. Thankfully, there was a voice of reason near the top of the thread that was saying, it's shot grub. The answer is shot grub. Even if you don't know what a shot grub is yet, the answer is shot grub. I've never seen this room in my life. I like it, though. Alright. It's a fun room, I guess. Alright, commando, double power, we got this. Got him. Beautiful. Whew. I'll refill that. Molotov launcher, exactly what you think. Had to imagine. I think I'll try and open a few rooms with a Molotov launcher. See if I can actually get some use out of it. Now I cannot afford to get hit. I need these Guan stones, yo. Love me a good Guan stone. Jeez. You've been rude as hell. Get off the podium. Excuse me? There we go. We solved the puzzle. The answer was, stand still. Alright, hopefully the shrine is on the inside. It can't be, yeah, there's no location for it. We could still have a keyman on the shop. I mean, it could even be directly in this room right now. Okay, we don't have keyman, but we do have remote bullets, which I definitely have to purchase. It's a 10% damage up as well as... Do I even just purchase it now? We might still have a black market on this floor. In the off chance that's the case, I'll not purchase that yet. Yo, what? Rude as hell. Did you see how I took that damage? Propel that motherfucker into my own face. God damn it. That was like the last opportunity I even had to take damage before I got to this room. Well, I guess we're not going to the Abbey, the true gun, I guess. I guess. That's a shame, I would have done it as well. Thank you. Funnily, the club is now going to be super accurate. Because RC is like the biggest accuracy up you can get. See what it did to that shotgun for an example. Yeah, Thunderclap is fine. I don't love Thunderclap, I don't hate Thunderclap. It's okay. I'm going to try and just use the crossbow and shotgun to clear this. What the fuck? That pot wouldn't break. I tried to roll against it and was just like, no, where the fuck do you think you're going? Great. We're losing a lot of armor to things that... Well, one of them at the very least is definitely a bug. There is a position in this map that just can't go through. Hate that I took damage to the gun fairy there. Yeah, mutation always works like this anyway, so it doesn't matter. I don't really get a bonus. I'm just gonna go destroy this. Thank you for the junk. Let's go get a key. Blank this room, get nothing. You already found the secret room, right? No, apparently we haven't. Interesting. Let's check the exit room. If it's not there, I'll just go back and blank a big room. I thought I'd found the secret room on this floor. Maybe it's just that I found it the last two floors and I'm assuming I still have that going on. You know, I think it's likely it's here and I just fucked up. It's off-center! That's why. Okay. I see you. Hey! The ability to steal. Is there anything I desperately want to steal on this floor? I don't think so. But it's nice to have the opportunity. Would I have stolen the RC bullets? The answer is actually yes. I definitely would have. Because Trork, the further spawns of Trork that happen in the future, they won't hold it against me. Hell, they won't even know that I did it. So it won't affect my further steals, and it'll save me 43, and it'll give me a level of curse, which can actually be particularly helpful. I would have done it. I'm going to use these two shots of the regular shotgun, rather. And then... change off. Man, I love just directing bullets. And this one This weapon is really great for it. Sadly, the poison effect doesn't really do too much against, you know, poison immune enemies like mushrooms and stuff. But it's still actually really good. Because the impact damage actually is significant on this gun as well. So against those enemies, I was kind of firing in a more conservative fashion. I was just trying to kill them with a single shot and then rely on the poison, finishing them off. But since there were so many enemies facing me at the same time, I should have just like auto-fired until they all died. Thank you for showing me which one's the correct one. Got him. Ah-ha-ha! No, steered off. Here we go. We've already got two key drops on this floor. This is amazing. The key drops are ridiculous. Yeah, this is gonna loop back again. It could be either one of these that goes the correct way. I'm gonna try this to the boss I'm talking about, obviously. Obviously, I don't have to worry about boss armor with random enemies on the floor, so I figured, why not save myself some ammunition there? And just trigger off the pox cannon. Thankfully, I got hit after the enemy had died, but still, non-optimal. Did I get it? Okay, I got it once. Second one should have... Second one didn't even kill it! Rude! Alright, what do you got, shop man? I've got two keys I want to go pick up, so... Irradiated lead. I think I have to steal that. It's gonna be pretty expensive. Yeah, 91. He's probably going to catch me, so I'll wait until I know whether or not I want to purchase the key. He shouldn't catch me if I do it correctly, but, you know, who's to say I'm going to do it correctly, right? It's me we're talking about after all. It's a third key spawn on this floor. Good lord. Okay, that actually destroyed a grenade. That was really big. Ho ho ho, you fucking... Stop it! Stop trying to cut me off! It's rude as hell! Any motorist will tell you that. I'm not a motorist. I have no ability to drive whatsoever, so I couldn't... tell you even what cutting someone off is. But I just know people complained about it a lot. Oh, we got the combo! Yeah, look at that shit! Ha ha! RC plus Crown of Guns. Good combo. Good combo right there, right there. Mmm, that's some good shit right there, right there. Good shit right there. Chorus in the background. Good shit, good shit. If I do say so myself. Damn it, the grenade was supposed to explode a lot earlier than that. Okay. The hell just happened? Oh, I think that was the BattleNet someone messaged you sound. Sorry, whoever messaged me on BattleNet, I am afraid I cannot respond. Right now, I am engaged in battle with the Gungeon. You must understand, it is very important. Stop giving me the worst Sega rooms! Never mind. Wait a second, that's also not necessary. I already have the world's best accuracy up. Dangers. Damn it! Missed one. It looks like they don't take damage from poison while they're submerged in poison. Alright, it looks like I also probably don't want to purchase the key this floor. So let's try and do the steal then. Was I out of the shop in time? Nope. Get out and don't come back. Alright. So, I think it's actually you need to get to the door. I think this is the area. Which means that I would have had to steal it from here. So that I could get out. Which means I probably actually would have had to purchase something before I could even steal it. Well, I tried. We're learning, alright? This is just a process of me learning more about how to steal. That's only going to deny me one shop anyhow, so it's not too bad. Man, Crown of Guns plus double vision is going to be fucking ridiculous for room clears. Holy shit. I, for one, can't wait. Yeah, especially with Gungeon Pep, I should just be able to... pretty much just disrespect these however I want. I'm gonna go Molotov plus Pox Cannon. Pretty clearly not what I wanted to do. I don't think I need more weapons at this point, so... oh, fuck you. I already have a level curse, so I can go to the secret room. The cursed room, anyway. Aim true thief! Well, I forgot that I have RC. Okay, I can get one. RC actually made that more difficult. I always forget that I have RC because I essentially just treat it like a huge accuracy up. Almost took more damage. Got him. Can I use a different weapon? Probably go to Thunderclap. It's just the bonus of the poison right now. We're not really one-shotting anymore. Poison's not really doing that much, especially considering I poison with normal shots anyway now. I'm gonna continue the pox cannon until it runs out at least. Okay, whoa, roll over the top. Everything's going well, except for when I try and shoot things at a longer range than I can reach with my mouse. Then things are typically going horribly. Almost out of ammunition in this weapon. Man, Molotov would be doing ridiculous things in this room. Shame I didn't swap to it. Alright, let's get the Molotov on the offhand, just in case. Now, we have already open to chest this floor, so we're not guaranteed to force the weapon from the boss. You don't have to pick up a weapon from the chest, it's just if you open a chest. I used to think it was you have to have gotten a weapon already. Turns out not to be the case. Refill the commando here. Got him. Hello? Oh. Beautiful. Thank you for the boss. This is almost certainly Warmonger. Obviously. Well, this is pretty damn hilarious. If only boss armor didn't exist. Got him. Flawlessly as well. And I managed to save the blank. Don't mind if I do. Gungeon with RC is actually even stupider. If you can believe that. Have a look at this. It's so good. It's like 100% accuracy. There's a gun muncher. There's a blank in that room. Didn't get it. Fine. It's a shame. It's a shame. Gungeon's super powerful at this point as well. It did not need a buff, and then it got a buff, and I am so happy about it. Okay. Damn it! Didn't see where the enemy had spawned until it was far too late. Okay, green up there. Don't mind if I do. I'll be going that far. Going for that in a second. Knock him in. No! I've got to remember, the reload on this gun is actually quite slow. Found the secret room. Hey, thank you for the hearts. Should have held on to that blank. I'm playing a little too hastily right now. Shelligan probably gets gun munched at this point. It's a level of curse that I don't need for damage that I don't really want. It's a fairly large amount of shots to really do any significant damage. Alright, what do I gun munch it with? Probably mutation. No, but I need one beam weapon. Oh no, Gungeon will do. Beautiful. All good. Puts two greens in and we get... Beautiful. Man, you probably had at least one item in here as well. Shame I missed out on it. My fault entirely, though. Well, is it? I thought I was testing the limits of what he considers to be his room. Unfortunately, I didn't escape the room in time. Just wanted to test if that was a secret room. I have no reason why, but I just looked at it and I was like, this kind of seems like a secret room here. Sometimes that instinct is 100% correct, and I just find random secret rooms where it was not too obvious that they should exist. And then sometimes it's incorrect. That's instinct for you. Okay, this is probably gonna loop back around. Do I care to get my item chest already? Not really. Should just wait until they leap at me and then roll out of the way. Alright, we'll see if this has a branching path, but I don't think it will. Okay. Oh shit! It's actually just straight up boss over here. So I was wrong about what was over there, but it is equally useless for me. Well, equally useful as well. If we count not useful at all as a measure of usefulness. Oh man, all of them were cool. Almost feel bad to kill them. Almost. I don't know why I really bothered flipping that over if I was planning to immediately kill the enemy anyway. But, who cares? That's done now. Should only be the occasional cursed enemy, despite the fact that I'd like there to be a few more. See, more cursed enemies means more money for me, means that if I end up with a shop that has something I want to purchase and something I want to steal, I'm in a really good position. Of course, we also need, you know, a shop with two things that we want in it. A lot of blank shops will have that, because, you know, each amulet you pick up makes all of the rest of the amulets better. So blank shops, but, you know, the forge can obviously have, like, two black or red tier items, and that's always handy. There's no need for me to go into that room yet. There is. The need for me to go into this room is just so that I don't have to go around that trap room again. So this should be the forge plus other special room split over here. Specifically because we've got another locked door down here that only happens next to the treasure room, so treasure room, probably forge in a dead end up here. I think I might end up actually having to use Gungeon for some of my room clears here. Didn't particularly think I was going to get away with that one, but I had to try. Beautiful. Yeah, we definitely take plus one. We probably want Gun Knight Helmet as well. So that'll be the one that we steal. And I can definitely do that. Hang on, no. Purchase this one first. Purchase the key. I'll leave the ammo because we were going to want that after the boss fight. Yeah, everything else immediately disappeared. I couldn't escape the room in time. I tried. I definitely tried. All right, let's go use the D-pad as some of our room clear. Right, of course, D-pad is actually excellent as well right now. Because of RC bullets. RC bullets are so good. I don't understand how it's only blue tier. I've forgotten the combo to do fireball. Really thought it was that, but it's not. Okay, and that's enough. That music's copyrighted, damn it. All right. Bugger. There's a secret room. All right, that's a really good gun. Probably only open one of these. Yes, it's this one. Yay, wrong choice. God damn it. Oh, I found that one again. I think it's this. I think it's down right. Down right. Maybe it's right down? Whatever. Origami. Origami already has the RC rocket trigger. Like, it does that by base. Either of these will work. I think I'll use Crown of Guns, though. Oh, baby. Thank you for doing that attack so much, because that's, like, really easy for me to avoid. In fact, it's very difficult for me to get hit by that attack. If I just keep firing forwards, I should be okay. Alright, let's get our last flawless here. Gotta remember, I don't have any extra speed or any extra dodge roll or anything like that. But so fucking mad. Thank you for shaping my damage so that I couldn't kill that in a single cycle. There we go, first hit. Jeez. I think if I actually had a few more bullets there, it actually would have worked as well. What'd you get me, doggy? It looks like you must have gotten me money. Just in case this is Sir Junkin in here, when I break it, we'll try. It's not going to be, but we'll still try. Alright, and boom, Sir Junkin, there we go. Collected him. Just in case. Alrighty then, for our room clears. I think we're on these two. It's just gonna be about fancy footwork, if anything else. If nothing else, rather. Should also try my absolute darndest to cut as much of the map out of my traversal, because we might start running low on ammunition. Wow, this is actually the wrong way. The worst thing is this is a really annoying room to do, just because it takes a lot of ammunition and you've got a lot of enemies, but it's a really annoying room to do, and it was unnecessary. That was my bad. I shouldn't have made that early roll. I should have known that was going to follow up. Oh well. Okay. Good clears. Now it's just shot grub. Rip. Alright, we're going in the wrong direction, but fixing our direction at this point would actually cost us more rooms than just heading along in the same wrong direction we've already chosen. It's not wrong, it's just longer. Should have known as soon as I went and rolled upwards that I was going to be dealing with the enemy that was coming from that area. Should also probably have chosen a penetrative weapon for this room, because this room is going to be a huge drain on my resources. Due to the fact that I didn't choose one. And then I just doubled down. I didn't even change to one when I realized it was wrong. Damn, I'm bad. No one? Thank you, Pink Wandstone. I was about to take damage there due to a really shitty roll. All right. Okay, Hegemony is actually doing a lot of work here. A lot more than I would have really expected from it, to be honest. Whee! Roll down. Hold off for a second, and... beauty. Got him. We are starting to run out of ammunition here as well. I think I should just be using the doubling anytime that I get it, just so that I can save myself ammunition. Not save it for specific rooms, but just use it whenever it's up. Double vision, I specifically mean here. Damn shot grubs! Whee! Show me what you got, buddy. Exactly. Didn't think so. Damn it, I really wanted meat bun right there. I wasn't even gonna call it, but I was... would have been excited as hell to get it. ...62 ammunition left in this weapon. Looks like we're likely still on the right path here. All seems good. If this takes a harsh turn downwards though, we're fucked. Nope, we're fine. I think it's actually too committed to this path now. I think we're definitely just going up. Solid armor, don't mind if I do. Alright then, now we're down to our next weapon. I think this is hammer at this point. This is a great weapon when you can actually estimate the amount of damage you need to do, but... sadly, I couldn't. Beautiful. Get back here. And no finale. Beautiful. I'm gonna go just straight up. That's my guess. I think straight up is the way that I need to be going. Now show me that I'm wrong. It's very rarely straight down the line. And of course it isn't this time either. Beautiful. Finale, let's pick up that health. No reason not to. Well, I mean, there's very, very slim reasons not to. Is there actually any reason not to pick up that health yet? If it was a half heart, you don't want to pick up that health just in case you spawn a green passive chest, which happens to have antidote in it, and then picking up that half heart later doubles it. But a full heart, I don't think... gets any increase. So I think there is no point in holding off at all. Nice. I actually really like using the hammer like this. Let's use it at super long range. Alrighty then. I'm gonna go with Crown of Guns. Just because it's so much more interesting. Okay, now I'm gonna change to Gungeon. Because it has piercing. I love it. I'm gonna use Gungeon against the second form and then go back to Crown of Guns. Why not, eh? Why not? I just love that it circles inside the body. It's definitely hitting a lot of boss armor right now. I'm almost certainly doing more damage when I don't double my shots. Because I don't think I hit boss armor until I do double my shots there. But doubling my shots looks so cool. I have to do it. Alright. Let's go back to this one for a while. This is a fun one. Yeah, thanks for trying, Lich. Thanks for trying. Did I take 2 damage in the Lich fight? I think I may have taken 2 damage in the Lich fight. Dang it, I missed the flawless there. Almost premature on that one. My name has been Rhapsody. The name of the game has been Into the Gungeon. Remote control bullets are absolutely fucking ridiculous. With weapons that shoot in many different directions, or weapons that are highly inaccurate. So, Gungeon for highly inaccurate, and weapons that shoot in many directions for the directional pad, the D-pad, and the Crown of Guns. I believe the Crown of Guns actually did benefit from the accuracy up that I got with the laser sight, and I think it narrowed the arc, because it used to shoot a lot further behind me, and then forwards, but instead, after I picked that up, it was mostly just all forwards. Anyhow, hopefully you've been enjoying yourselves, and hopefully we'll see you next time.